Dr. Leachon, Iloilo City set to declare a state of calamity due to the pertussis outbreak in the city. How big of a threat is this viral infection, considering that 35 out of 453 cases in the country have already died?
Well, this is a potentially life-threatening illness, but not as much as the COVID pandemic. During the COVID pandemic, we don't have much vaccines. And of course, the global companies raced in 10 months to produce the first vaccine for the COVID pandemic. Well, for this one, there are some people or kids who have been vaccinated, but some babies perhaps born during the pandemic may not have the vaccination. And the sad part is that, just like in the past, our preparation in terms of procuring the vaccines is actually quite slow, and the anticipation is very important. Perhaps during the COVID pandemic, what we should have done is to stockpile already vaccines that we usually give out routinely to the children. But because of the COVID pandemic and the lockdowns, and of course misinformation towards vaccine, and if you remember the COVID pandemic vaccines, even if there were supplies already at the warehouse, these were not deployed because of the problem in implementation, execution, and distribution, as well as the misinformation brought about by some sectors, anti-vaccine sectors, and of course leading to misinformation of the public. But here is quite different, because you have here an old virus trying to exist right now because of the absence of the vaccines. It's an old one. I remember this in medicine, and I have not seen this kind of cases now than before. So therefore, the approach for this one, since we don't have any vaccines, and if there are vaccines, there are not enough for the entire outbreak areas like Quezon City, which is a huge population city, and then Iloilo, is basically to put on their face masks and minimum public health standards while facilitate the giving of antibiotics through mobile vans and putting them near the resident homes so that they can actually treat those who are actually infected. And then once the vaccines are here, and then again using the approach that bringing health to the resident homes would be the best. So because these are poor kids without much any funding or help, so the best way is to do that. So for the moment, I think face masking and minimum public standards will be good. Antibiotics for those infected already, and then vaccination for those uninfected, whatever will be enough for them. And then stockpiling for future problems, not only for pertussis, but also for diphtheria, measles, and other viral illnesses, which we usually give out during birth sa mga bata. I think that's very important na gawin natin. And there must be a national immunization strategy, and then ask the LGUs for scorecard or checklist so that we will know the percentage of vaccination of a particular viral illness so that we can deploy right away, and how much we will order based on the data they will submit to us.
All right, Dr. Leachon, you mentioned the importance of wearing face masks as we face this viral infection in different parts of the country. Would you actually recommend to the government to reimpose the mandatory wearing of face masks in public areas?
Yes, I would recommend it without any hesitation, because we don't have any protection right now for the kids, and only for the outbreak areas and voluntary for those people who would like it. Because the kids, they are very vulnerable, and the carriers here will be the adults. The adults are the ones going out. So the prevention of the whooping cough It's very important for pregnant women. Very important also that we cover the nose and mouth because this will be the sources of the infection. Washing of hands is important, just like during the pandemic. And if you think that you have pertussis because of the whooping cough, the fatigue, and the difficulty breathing, vomiting, and all, then you go to the center. But protect yourself because the mode of transmission, ladies and gentlemen, is droplet infection, direct contact, so wash your hands. And most children contract this infection from their playmates who are in the early stages of the disease. So these are important information that would support the wearing of the face mask and the installation of minimum public health standards.
Dr. Leachon, you mentioned the importance of safeguarding pregnant women against pertussis. Will a baby actually have any complications if a pregnant woman, if a woman actually contracts pertussis during her pregnancy?
Yes, they are the vulnerable ones. And we usually protect the pregnant women. We provide, when we actually vaccinate them, we give them 90% protection to the newborn child. And that's very important. So I emphasize this kasi the Philippines is known for in Southeast Asia as a country with a lot of pregnant women. Marami tayong yan. So sa mga pregnant women, unahin po kayo because of the risk of contracting disease that will be transmitted to the newborn child.
Meaning, sir, if a pregnant woman actually contracts pertussis, there is a very high chance that the once the baby is out, more or less, that baby is already infected with pertussis upon his or her birth?
Right. It's a vertical transmission, and the probability is about 90% based 90%.
Quite
vulnerable.
Quite a high probability for someone who does not have any vaccines at the moment, given that that is a newborn baby. But speaking of vaccines, we have heard a lot about vaccinating, the importance of vaccinating young children against pertussis. But what about adults? What can they actually do to increase their immunity against the disease?
Well, they have also vaccination for people of all ages would need actually whooping cough vaccines based on the CDC recommendation. For young children, they have the capital DAP, that's diphtheria, tetanus, and of course pertussis for 2, 4, and 6 months, and 15 through 18 months, and 4 through 6 years. Now for preteens, 11 to 12 years, they need the Tdap, capital D, DAP, and then for pregnant women, as mentioned, during their 27 to 36 week of each pregnancy, they should be given. And for adults, anytime for those who have never received that. So, but the main priority to me is the young children because they don't have the capacity, they don't have the immunity as yet compared to the adults who have been exposed to this kind of problems in the past. So I think the priority should be the young children because they're vulnerable. They don't complain much even if they're having problems. And also the lack of pediatric intensive care units may actually be a problem as well. So the best way is actually prioritize the children. And if the children are actually infected and they have symptoms, then they should be given right away the medications, the antibiotics. Because if you give this late in the ball game, this may not be effective anymore. And the toxins may spread throughout the body and may actually cause problems. So in the vaccination area, you actually protect the ones who are in your household. That's very, very important, I think. And we should actually protect the babies because they are vulnerable. And when you have the vaccine, you also protect the other people inside the house. That is very, very important.
Right. Doctor, I understand that one of the deadly symptoms of pertussis is apnea. How do you actually prevent that or address that once you have a pertussis patient in your home?
Well, when you have apnea because of coughing, you have problems with that. No? That's why most of these cases, they are brought to the hospitals. They were given, they will be given, of course, nebulizers. But if there will be difficulty, because the ordinary mixtures of suppressants and expectorants may not be effective, because their lining, their cilia is the protective epithelium, are denuded, and therefore their protection to cough up the phlegms may not be there. So sometimes because of oxygen desaturation, then you might be able to intubate the patient and put the patient on mechanical ventilator just to save them. So these are the things that we usually see during our time when pertussis was more prevalent than now. So that's the way it is.
Doc, we understand that the incubation period of the virus ranges between 7 and 10 days before the major symptoms actually occur or actually manifest. How long does the disease actually last? Because in China, they also refer to pertussis as the 100-day cough.
Well, the pertussis will spread to 18 persons. That's the RO or reproduction number. The pertussis vaccine does not prevent asymptomatic infection or transmission. So the incubation period may actually a few days up to 3 days, but it may last to 3 weeks and then 2 months that you may have these debilitating symptoms. And thus you need to start early off with the antibiotics, but because it will not be effective anymore if you will give it late in the ball game. So if you give it on the third month, I don't think it will be effective anymore. So the best way is actually give them early on to prevent the escalation of patients that will actually need pediatric intensive care unit. Early treatment is effective for reducing symptoms, ladies and gentlemen. And treatment should begin the first 1-2 weeks before coughing, paroxysm occurs, so that the symptoms will be lessened. Antibiotics, my friends, will not alter the course of illness or prevent transmission if given late in the disease. And therefore, this should be right now be communicated to the public right now through the Department of Health and the LGU. Now, strongly consider treating any of the following. Clinical history suggestive of pertussis if you have the whooping cough, at risk for severe or complicated disease in infants, and person as soon or will have routine contact with someone with high risk, pregnant women, mga asawa, yan. Very important. And get your kids vaccinated if there are supplies in your LGU. So many kids skip routine vaccines during the lockdowns and are back in school right now. So you have to go back to your health centers because there are free po yan para sa mga health centers po.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Leachon, what should the public prepare at home to ensure that they have enough supplies to address should a member of their family actually contract pertussis?
Well, I think right now with the present situation, the unvaccinated young infants and children were affected. A lot of them are the adults that are mildly symptomatic. Now, ako, ang suggestion ko is a high level of education, engagement, and empowerment. You protect them by doing the minimum health public health standards. Huwag lumabas muna ang mga batang yan because they are unprotected. Now, the elderly na namamalengke or going out for work, you should wear masks kasi kayo po yung carriers. The low vaccine coverage in kids plus the low vaccine coverage in adults, yan na nagkakos ng outbreak. So therefore, the best way is not give the bacteria a chance to penetrate the mouth, nose, and throat, which are the portals of entry. Ang mga komplikasyon ng pertussis, pag hindi tumitigil ang ubo, pwedeng mabawasan talaga ang entry ng hangin. That will cause the apnea and respiratory failure leading to pneumonia. Napakadelikado. This is extremely dangerous, especially among infants without vaccination. So isa yan sa dapat nating gawin. And then adults, kaya importante for the adults that you go to the doctor, especially yung may edad na. You need to be vaccinated as well, at least protected kayo from the symptoms so that you will not actually transmit this to the kids. Ayan ang suggestion namin.
And Dr. Tony, when do they actually know if it's time to take themselves or their children to hospitals to be confined already?
Well, to me, the moment you have symptoms already, because it's prevalent right now, you have to go for antibiotics so that you will not proceed to the severe symptoms that will need hospitalization. It's still the sense of urgency, the visionary approach that will be needed here. So, sabi ko nga, it will not be effective if you start treatment 3 weeks after the infection. Wala na, too late the hero by that time.
Mm-hmm.
So, and also prevention is better than a pound of cure. And I think we must remember this based on our experience on the COVID pandemic. So, in summary, if you don't have any vaccines right now in your area, wear your face mask and do the minimum public health standards. If you have vaccines in your areas, so go out and procure that. If you have symptoms already, then you get the antibiotics right away. Now, if your LGU is far, then request from your barangay captain or a mobile clinic to be deployed and bring the medicines and the medical personnel to the sites or the residents of the ones affected. And in Quezon City, this will be Payatas and other more populated areas in the city here and, of course, in Iloilo.
And Dr. Oni, finally, the Department of Health says that cases of pertussis in the National Capital Region are already plateauing, but despite that, 10 other regions are seeing spikes in pertussis cases. How far is the Philippines actually from having a nationwide pertussis outbreak?
Well, it's not far that you can have this because we are archipelago and mobility is not actually curtailed. So maybe the plateauing may be secondary to underestimation or underreporting. We might not be able to the true picture, but it's a relief for me if the numbers are plateauing. But we must prepare for escalation in other areas like Calabarzon because of its proximity to NCR and of course to South Luzon and of course to Central Luzon and also to tourist destination areas like Iloilo because of Boracay, Cebu, Palawan, those areas in the beaches because these are the areas where people will go during the Holy Week. While the others are actually enjoying, the ones who are vulnerable, particularly in those Pag-asa area, Paseco area, they should be the ones be given the vaccination and deploy medical personnel through their ambulance and mobile vans so that we use the Holy Week as a period to reset, recharge, and prepare, no? Recharge and re-energize the people through vaccination so that next week our problems will be lesser and hopefully pertussis will be controlled by that time.
Do you actually expect the Philippines to face a further spike in pertussis cases considering that Holy Week is dawning upon us? Passengers will be flocking into terminals, airports, seaports, and as you mentioned, a lot of people will be spending their time in beaches and in other crowded destinations.
Well, I expect in the next 3 weeks that this will actually go up because of the mobility of people and because of the cavalier attitude of our countrymen not to wear masks. So I expect that there will be a surge of pertussis cases in the country, particularly outside of the NCR.
All right, let's keep our fingers crossed there. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, health reform advocate Dr. Tony Leachon.
Thank you very much, Katrina. Good morning.